As we continue our exploration of quantum body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, more vital life, my forthcoming book with Jack Tuzinski and Brian Ferting. Jack is a professor of quantum biology and quantum mechanics. Brian Ferting is a professor of endocrinology like myself, although he's more recent than I am. I'm kind of ancient relic at the moment. So here's a question I want to pose. Is it possible that the collapse of the wave function is related to the quantum field appearing as both observer and observed through its own self-interaction? Has this hypothesis been explored by physicists? And it turns out it has, although it's in its early stages of development. So one way to think about this possibility is that the quantum field is constantly interacting with itself. This interaction can be thought of as a kind of a feedback loop where the field is both observing itself and being observed by itself. When a measurement is made, this feedback loop can amplify the effect of the measurement, leading to what is called the collapse of the wave function. Another way to think about this possibility is that the quantum field is not simply a collection of particles, but rather a unified whole. When a measurement is made, the wholeness is somehow disrupted, leading to the collapse of the wave function. So there are a number of models, different theoretical models that have been proposed to explain the quantum field and how the quantum field could collapse on its own wave function. One model called the decoherence program suggests that the collapse of the wave function is caused by the entanglement of the system being measured with the environment, which is supposed to be a classical field in space and time. Another model called the many worlds interpretation suggests that the wave function does not collapse, but rather splits into multiple branches, each of which corresponds to a different possible outcome of the measurement, leading to what is called the multiverse theory. So here are some specific examples of how the quantum field could appear as both observer and observed through its own self-interaction. One, measurements of the electromagnetic field. When we measure the electromagnetic field, we are essentially interacting with the quantum field. This interaction could cause the field to collapse on its own wave function, leading to the measurement result. Two, measurements of the weak nuclear force. The weak nuclear force is responsible for radioactive decay. When a radioactive atom decays, it emits a particle that interacts with the weak nuclear force. This interaction could cause the weak nuclear field to collapse its own wave function, leading to the decay event. I mentioned previously something called the Zeno effect, the quantum Zeno effect. If you continue the measurement non-stop, then radioactive decay ceases or slows down, suggesting that consciousness has a role. Measurement of quantum gravity. Quantum gravity is a theory that attempts to unify quantum mechanics in general relativity. If quantum gravity is correct, then gravity would be mediated by a quantum field. When we measure gravity, we are essentially interacting with this quantum field. This interaction could cause the field to collapse on its own wave function, leading to the measurement result. So you see many, many theories and many, many propositions. Basic idea to resolve all these conflicts is that the quantum field is self-aware. And it knows itself as both the knower and the known, and the collapse is the mode of knowing. Whether that no mode of knowing is an observation, a thought, a feeling, an emotion, or even an image, those are modes of knowing. Seeing is a mode of knowing. And how do we know? quantum particles through observation, through seeing. So seeing is the collapse, and it creates both the seer and the scenery. Let me know what you think about this.